Welcome. Dave,
thank you.
How are you?
Hello, Joe. How are you doing?
I'm well.
Thank you
Glad
very much.
Glad to have you here.
Our pleasure to be here. Thank you.
You guys have been playing for more than 30 years together.
This is true.
Giving real energetic shows full of joy. I can say fun is key when it
yes.
comes to your performances.
Yes, you probably can relate. You have a fun job too, right?
Yeah, true.
We gotta have fun if we're gonna do something like this.
Definitely. You
know? So it's still a challenge, but it's still really fun, even after all these years.
Yeah, because that's what I'm curious about. Has it always been fun? I mean, or maybe during the years, has
well,
it been become more enjoyable?
Well, it's enjoyable to play together again because we did take a break in between this. Mm-hmm. And we've all been on, you know, a lot of other records and we've doing other projects, but we started out a long time ago and we went really hard. We came over to Holland in the late 80s and we were very fortunate. We got a really good agent, Arnold Wagner and Carlos Van Heet with Mojo, and he helped us get so many big festivals, and pretty soon
Can
we were
remember
gone
which
almost
ones?
The whole, we've played Pink Pop, we've played Lowlands, we've played Paradiso many times, and Milky
great.
Way, and all over your country is so great. But we really went after it. We had a lot of records come out pretty, you know, successively, and we stayed working the whole time. Most years we played over 200 shows per year. So sometimes
That's a
we
lot.
Were a little bit burned out, you
I
know,
can
and
imagine.
So now when we come back together, and now we just got a new record out.
Yes.
Which the new song we just sang is our brand new song, New World.
New World.
Yeah.
Is this an album that you guys created while having the break?
We were coming together in the beginning of this year in January. And we already had a few songs already on the tape recorder because it's all analog recording still.
That's what you love,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's what we love. And Thomas has a fantastic studio near San Diego, California. Mm. So I'm living in Texas, near Austin, Texas, and Brian's living in Phoenix, Arizona. And so we finally came over there in January, and this was really the last song I brought to Tom. He's the producer of the album.
Great.
And I said, I got this song. It might be a little bit different from most of the other Paladin songs, but after all these years, and I think we have about maybe 15 albums over all these years,
yeah.
You gotta come up with something. I feel like you need to come up with something a little bit
sure.
different every time to spread your wings and try a new sound and try a new song. And this song,
message.
A new message.
New message
so,
also.
New World was a message that, you know, we all know you guys live a lot closer to a lot of the turmoil than we do, but there's so many crazy things going on in the world. And I think one of the key lines in this whole song is love, not hate, before it's too late.
Wow, beautiful.
So I want to just get everybody who believes in that to try to say, you know, it is one of these things that we got to, you know, try to get love. Love is the answer.
Yeah.
It should be anyways, you know, I mean, I sound like an old hippie, but, but it's really true, you know.
And
our parents were probably saying, oh, my God, what's the world happening now? And their parents were telling them the same thing. Oh, my God, this world, what is it? You know,
yeah.
So every generation has this.
Yeah.
And now that we're becoming older, you know, when we were young, rock and roll, get in the van, take off, go all over, whatever you can do, rock and roll, man, is all. That's what it was all about. But when you become older, Thomas has some children, Brian too, you know, I don't have any, but I have some beautiful nieces and nephews and stuff, and I think, what are we gonna leave for them? You know, what message do they see? You know, so
I think this message is pretty universal, and I think, you know, his grandkids and everyone would understand.
I hope so.
What else has changed for you guys over the years? I mean, apart from you did 200 shows before, this time around, I think you're taking it
many years.
More easier.
Yeah.
But for example, the music industry has changed
a
lot
tremendously,
over the years.
Tremendously,
is that something that has had an effect on your music?
Well, we're trying to
shows.
We're kind of not playing the game like we when we started out, we tried to get a record company and we tried to do all these special shows and we had a manager, you got to be here and play this show and open for the and all that. And now, you know, we're more like we take a little bit more easy. Thomas is the record company now.
So what are you going to play for us next?
It's a song about the water and the water everybody needs to drink, and we need good water. But where we live, in the southwest of the United States, there hasn't been very much rain for a long time. And there's a lot of controversy. The farmers can't get the water for the crops, and you can't go and wash your car, or you got to be very careful not to use too much water. But then also then they can still keep building more and more houses every time you look. There's more houses being built. So where do they get the water? And then I know some people that are neighbors of mine that have a big ranch. They're growing avocados, really nice ones. And they have their own well in the ground.
Wow.
And then the government says, you can't take the water out of the ground anymore. You have to buy the water from the waterman. So then they get to the point where they pay $3,000 every month to water the avocados. Then the government says, you use too much water, you can't have this much water anymore. We kept going around talking to each other, man, this is crazy. Who owns the water? How can they sell you the water? So we decided to write this song, Who Sold the Water to the Waterman?
We're gonna listen to you, the Paladins.
Okay, here it is. Ready?